these are all wild speculation. In the first place, I have not inspired anyone to make this venture. I cannot, preempt the role of the Sultan behind this. And to finance it, out of the question, of course. If indeed I am that well off, why should I finance the adventure of the Sultan's men? You see, only about 100 people, 200 people like that. That's not my way of doing things, you know. Recently, when we decided to uproot and break the backbone of the well-entrenched kidnapper ransom movement, the Abu Sayyaf group, we mobilized at least 4,000 regular forces of the MNLF just to, resolve our problem, our dilemma over the existence of the Abu Sayyaf. I mobilized over 4,000. Yeah. Earlier, when there was this Sipadan incident, way back several years ago, and when I was assigned to solve the problem by President Estrada, I also mobilized about 5,000 MNLF regular forces.
Chairman Misuari, would you allow?
So, for anyone to speculate that I have anything to do with this is a kind of madness. It's very responsible for anybody to implicate me in this. But to say that I am not concerned over the fate of the young man is wrong. I have warned the Malaysian government. The first time I was interviewed by the Australian radio station, when I was asked to comment on the fate of the young man who went to across the sea to our homeland, Sabah, I told them that every drop of their blood is sacred to us. All of us, Tausug, including the Moro National Liberation Front, with its over 1 million armed forces now. And then, before I left Sambong a few days ago, on my way to Manila with my wife, Adya Tarhata here, I was interviewed by Kabayan Noli de Castro during his early morning program with the ABS-CBN. I added kind of advice
team
to touch our civilian. I said, once you do that, that would tantamount to declaration of war against our people and the Moro National Liberation Front. Because it's our sacred duty to protect our people. We have over 1.5 million living across every part of Sabah. Not to speak of Sarawak, which is also an integral part of a sovereign territory known as North Borneo. So I'm so happy that they have put some restraint on this question of our people there, the civilians. But it's just that I don't know how exactly what's happening to the young people who have, who have decided to defend themselves against the massive attack from the armed forces of Malaysia. I don't know. I understand they've been cut off from contact because some people have decided to destroy the cell site, so they could not be contacted anymore. So I don't know anything about it anymore. Since I left Manila for Davao and then to Sarangani province, I stayed a couple of days there, and only yesterday I returned back to Manila. So this is all what I know, except that before I left the hotel at the Makati Shangri-La, I saw a report.
MNLF Chief Nur Misuari in Taguig, where the press conferences of the Sulu Sultanate are being held. He's just saying that he denies being involved in the sending of people to Sabah, and all stories about his involvement are just wild speculations. Earlier we had a press conference from the Department of Foreign Affairs headed by Assistant Secretary Raul Hernandez confirming the airstrikes and ground attacks. Reading the statement of Secretary Albert de Rosario from Kuala Lumpur, who said that we came to Malaysia to walk the last mile to try to save lives, and we will continue to do that. The Secretary is expected to return here to the country between 4 to 5 in the afternoon. We'll have more news for you in a few minutes. Please stay tuned.